In a previous video, I showed you how to create a publish geometry feature, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a copy geometry feature. So first off, in my transmission assembly, I'm going to create a new component. So I'll click on the create command in the ribbon, and the type is set to part. I'll go ahead and enter in the number that I want to use for this next component. Click OK. I'm using my standard start part. And for locating this component, I'm just going to use the default constraint. I can access that from the right mouse button menu. I hit the check mark or middle mouse button, and my component is placed in the model. I'm going to click on it and choose activate so I can create the copy geometry feature inside of it. Then from the ribbon, click on copy geometry. And first off, in the upper left-hand corner of the dashboard, I can choose the context, either assembly or external. The difference between the two is that if I leave the default assembly, then this copy geometry feature is going to have a reference path up to the top level assembly in which it was created. And if I choose external, the copy geometry feature reference path is just going to be between the target part and the source part. And so that's why I prefer to use external, because it minimizes external references. Then I'll click the open button so that I can select the component that I want to reference. And since I use the context type of external, I've got to locate the copy geometry feature in my target model. And that's why I have this placement dialog box that comes up. And I've generally found that almost all the time you can use the placement method of default, but if for some reason you needed to locate explicitly where that copy geometry feature should be located in the target part, you could use a coordinate system to do that. So I will click OK, and I'm going to open up the References tab. I have a config.pro option set so that I can automatically start picking geometry from the model that I want to reference: surfaces, edge chains, and datum features. But I'm going to use this button on the dashboard to specify that I want to pick a published geometry feature. And you get an accessory window that opens up, and so you might be able to select the published geometry feature in that window. Also, you get a split model tree that shows the target component. And you could scroll down, and here I've located that published geometry feature that I made before. I can click on it, and we can see that it is listed in here. A couple other things to show you. From the Options tab, here I have the ability to specify when this should update. This is called Update Control. And the default is automatic. In other words, whenever I regenerate, it's going to update the copy geometry feature. If you don't want it to change, you could set it to manual update, and we have this option here to provide a notification. Or if you don't want to have any kind of update, you could choose no dependency. And be aware that no dependency is pretty much a one-way trip. It used to be always a one-way trip. Once you set it to no dependency, you couldn't go back. Here it's giving me this warning over here, but be aware there is a hidden config.pro option that allows you to reestablish dependency. PTC doesn't make a big amount of noise over this, but you actually do have that ability. All right, now to the Properties tab. I highly recommend that you rename your copy geometry features. I like to call them ECG for external copy geometry, or just CG for copy geometry, and then the name or number of the part that you're referencing. This can be a help later on for debugging a model if somehow you lose some references. So after I've changed the name, I can hit the check mark. And if I go down to this part and expand it in the model tree, you can see that it has the copy geometry feature in there. Now I can go ahead and open up in its own separate window, and you can see the geometry that has been copied over, including some datums. Remember that a copy geometry feature can reference one component and one component only. So if I want to grab additional references from another part, I have to create a second copy geometry feature. So again, I'm going to go back to my part. I'm going to activate it. By the way, I hid the previous copy geometry so that the references won't clutter up my graphics area. And so for creating my new copy geometry feature, I'll click the button. And this time I'm going to leave it as assembly context just to show you that difference. Now I'll go to the references tab over here, and then I can select the surfaces that I want. And be aware that you can right mouse click and hold, and from the pop-up menu, if you choose solid surfaces, that's a quick way of grabbing all the different surfaces from a part. Just like when we created the publish geometry feature, there's a details button that allows you to create different surface sets if you need to. All right, then here I can click in the collector in order to select any edges that I want. Maybe I want to make sure that I explicitly grab a couple of the ones for the hole over here. Maybe I'm going to need them later on. And you can also select any references from the model, like datum planes, axes, points, and coordinate systems. And again, you could click in the collector in order to activate it, or you can right mouse click and hold and choose references so that it activates the collector. And I'll go ahead and turn on my datum plane visibility. And looks like I can't access the planes because they're hidden on a layer, so no problem. I have my layers command in my quick access toolbar in the top of the screen. I can use the pick icon to activate the part. And then let's go and show any of the different references in here. I can close the layer tool, turn on my axis display, and then pick the references that I need. So for example, I could grab an axis over here, axis over there. If I had any annotations, I could click on the edit button and then select those. And again, from the options tab, you have the update control, but since I am selecting geometry, we have surface copying options like copy all surfaces as is, or you could use the option to exclude surfaces and fill holes, or copy inside a boundary. This is very similar to what you have in the copy and paste commands. And again, for the properties tab, I'll type in CG, and oh yeah, I forgot the name of the part over here. Let me go and cheat real quick. It is 51103. Hit the enter key. Now I can hit the check mark. And again, I will open up the part in its own separate window. And you can see that I have the first copy geometry feature hidden. And you can see all the geometry that I brought in from the second copy geometry feature. Let me show the first one. And now I've got the different references I need so I can begin designing my part.